How to create a quick pattern design using the pattern preview feature in Photoshop. Go to the File menu and New. Then just create a document width maybe 2000 by 2000, that's what I'm going for, and also background contents. You could go with white, black. However, if you want a nice, useful pattern feel, I always think that transparent's really useful. So transparent and click Create. So where's Pattern Preview in Photoshop? Go to View and Pattern Preview. Click there and now you're in Pattern Preview mode. What that means is you've got this central blue line around here and that's the same size as your original document. And now all these spaces outside are just repeat tiles of the same design. So anything you create inside or outside will be used as the pattern. You can always remove it, just go to View and Pattern Preview off, and it's back just to the original document. So let's just go View, Pattern Preview, and I'm just going to use a very basic shape, triangle tool, something like a triangle tool, and I'm going to be using greens. So I'm just going to go here, greens and blues, some of these colours, and I'm just going to apply it in the centre. So you can see as I apply it, that now is repeated. You can see now with the zoom, you can see it repeated endlessly outwards. Now, that's an okay pattern, but I want to make slightly more complicated pattern than that. So let's just go back again to see the tile. Now, you can, if you wish, add the design outside. So if I add it outside here, just add it like there, it doesn't matter. There is a tile, you just don't see it. It's a pity, really, many ways that they don't have a sort of red sort of border as well for those. However, it is repeated, so you can just see it there. So anything you create outside is again repeated there, and you can see the same result there in that central tile. You can also apply across it as well, so you've got that border, and then you can see it, that bit there is repeated there, and you can repeat there, and you also can go here. So if I just go over that border again along that scent there, just release, now it's repeated over here as well. So if I change the color, let's just show again. You can see now it's repeated on that line. Likewise, if I go down to change the color again, let's just go down here and repeat that. It's repeated up there and it's repeated endlessly around the whole thing in those square tiles. And you can do that, create more and more of these designs. The reason I've gone for transparency, it's just great when you're creating, say, random field designs or other fields where you want maybe multiple layers without blending. You can just create it so you can actually see the layers below. So I can add some more of these and overlap. And once you're happy with the design, you've got this design here. That is the pattern tile. And you can go over here to Edit and Define Pattern. So click there and then just define it. Anything that's inside that tile will now be defined as that pattern and added to your presets. You don't have to use just triangles, of course. You could use any kinds of things like brushes. However, gradients are not so great. I'm just going to go with circles. So just create a circle, maybe different colors. And again, that is repeated. You can see the repeated there, again, there and there and there. Off upwards and downwards. And I can add additional ones, and you see every time I add it, it's just added there. If I add it there, it's added again, and so on. It's just repeated across that tile. And I can add multiple ones there and apply it in the center. And again, you can see there again, it's repeated. Once you're happy with that, you can always go to Edit and again, Define Pattern. So it's just stored away, click OK. Now you can also, if you want, go and add other effects. However, just make certain you avoid breaking the edge. So if you just go over here, make a selection, and then say, go to Filter and Blur and Gaussian Blur. And you can then apply a blur effect. So you can create some slight variations on the theme there. But however, if you try this over the edge, so if I select that and apply the effect, you can see what happens. It doesn't like it, it will split it. And the result maybe is not exactly what you think. So just avoid the edges if you're doing selections. but you can use selections and you can use effects to a degree, just avoid the edge. So deselect there. And again, edit and define pattern and so on. You can do repeatedly. You can also save this to your library, which is useful because then you can use this pattern tile maybe in Creative Express. That's also an option. If you no longer need the pattern preview, go to View and Pattern Preview and just turns it off. Then you can go to Edit and Fill. And I'm just going to apply that pattern. Just going to go down here, select the pattern design. There you can see the pattern preset. And make certain the script is on. Sometimes, for some weird reason, it just ignores this. So I always click it on and off again to make certain that it actually uses it. And click OK. And just apply it. You can set the density, size, scale, etc. Rotate pattern, color randomness. Click OK. And apply your design. And you can repeat it. So edit and fill. And again, click it, make certain it's on. Just ignores it sometimes. I don't know why, but it just seems to have a slight bug where it just completely ignores it. There. So you've got the design there, and that pattern design, of course, you can then save to your library, etc. Hope you found this tutorial of interest. Thank you very much.